is the innate sense of Americans. I think that people all over the world want to help each other out in times of disaster. But there is something else that I think is worth noting, and that is that there have been a couple of pictures that I think people find really moving, and I think they're moving for a reason. There's one picture in particular that I thought was very moving. It's a picture of a man. All of this is an overriding of the innate biological good diversity between men, women, and children that truly does exist. Okay, speaking of all of that, I want to talk a little bit about the National Statement. So, for people who don't know what the National Statement is, the evangelical community has brought out something called the National Statement. Okay, on Friday, from biblical manhood, quoted by the ethics and religion, the government should get completely out of the business of marriage. I agree, it's a covenant made before God. I don't know what government has to do with a covenant made before God. Article 2 says, we affirm that God's revealed will for all people is chastity outside of marriage and fidelity within marriage. Okay, again, agreed. I was a virgin until they say, we did that, and I think a significant difference actually between Christian thought and Jewish thought. Jewish thought is very little about what you think and very much about what you do, and Christian thought is very much about what you feel as well as what you do. So, this is the difference, but to suggest that this isn't in line with Christian thinking for the last 1,000 years is just asinine. You know, this is everything they say here, in other words, is totally within bounds of Christianity. And yet the left is super mad, because the left is super mad that there are people who disagree with diversity for the left on September 14th in Brooklyn. I want to make a quick distinction between my event and the Free Speech Week that comes, I believe, a week and a half later in Berkeley. That's the one featuring Ann Coulter and maybe Steve Bannon and maybe Milo. I believe Milo is definitely going to speak there. He's the one going on. That's happening after my event. My event is September 14th. Both of them have been approved by Berkeley, but just the news coverage has been inflating the two. They're not the same event, and not all the people hold the same views, obviously. But regardless, everybody has the right to have a right to free speech. Held near and dear by a lot of the early conservatives in the country was Edmund Burke's reflections on the revolution in France. One of the great differences between some of the founders was how they felt about the French Revolution. Some people, like John Adams, saw the French Revolution as dangerous, which it was. Some people
said it was out of line. I get that comedy is about pushing the boundaries and being politically correct, and that's fine. But do you not agree that that picture holding up a severed head, I know it's a mask covered in tomato sauce, but do you not accept that wasn't a
people who've been very critical of Trump? I mean, he's going after sitting senators of his own party. He's going after Jeff Flake, a senator of his own party. The hell is Don Lemon talking about? Again, everything from the left has to be infused with this extra degree of voracious nastiness. And when you do that, all you're doing is
it's the smartest thing to do. Like, people are really breaking down, and y'all sitting here with cameras and microphones trying to ask them what the fuck is wrong with us.
So
and
sorry.
You're really trying to understand with the microphone down in my face. With me shivering cold, and my kids wet, and you still putting a microphone
sorry.
In my face.
Sorry.
Okay, so look at this woman. This woman's really speaking the Lord and says, for this is to me as the waters of Noah, as I swore that the waters of Noah shall never again pass over the earth, so I swore neither to be wroth with you nor to rebuke you. Okay, so I thought that this was a good biblical reading for a time when so many people have been evacuated from their homes in what, I mean, frankly, was like biblical scale flooding. And this is just incredible stuff.
You on the page and type in Clavin. Hey, Austin, how do you spell that? No. It's K-L-A-V-N. Well, I'm talking to myself here. Stickers.com. Flavin.
Ask us what the fuck is wrong with us.
So I'm so
and
sorry.
You're really trying to understand it with the microphone still in my face.
So, I have to say that obviously we'd be all up to see reporters get yelled at, but the woman, I actually felt for the woman from CNN. That's her job. That is her job. I have to do this job. It is so impressive. In the water and a truck driver stuck inside. Remember, this is a woman who's getting a big chance of her career. She wants to stay on camera and do a good job. Ed Lavantera from CNN saw an elderly couple in help on the KTRK, which is an ABC affiliate, reporter Fody Hilarious, rescued some disabled people off a roof. And my even though it's it's not as important.